Welcome to DSS online classes. My name is Neha Singh and I will teach you science. So in the last video we were studying about chapter number 5, that is separation of substances. And the topic for today is sedimentation, decantation and filtration. So let us begin with our topic. You will look carefully at the diagram. First of all, what you have to do is you will take a container half filled with water. In the same container, you will add some soil. You will add some soil to the same container and will leave it undisturbed for few minutes. After few minutes, you will observe the container and you will notice that the soil you added has been settled down while the water is floating above the surface. At the surface, so the soil that has been settled down is termed as sediment. And the water that is floating at the surface above the soil is termed as supernatant liquid. And this whole process of settling down of solid particles at the base and floating of liquid particles at the surface is termed as sedimentation. Sedimentation is the process of separation in which insoluble particles in a solid liquid mixture settle down at the base. After sedimentation, you can easily pour this water, this supernatant liquid, into another vessel without disturbing the sediment. So, without disturbing the sediment and pouring down of this water into another vessel is termed as decantation. Once you have done the sedimentation process, aap kya kar sakte ho? Ye jo upar liquid float kar raha hai, jise hum supernatant liquid kehte hain, isko aap carefully pour कर दोगे और आप ऐसे pour करोगे कि इसका जो sediment वाला part है, जो soil है, जो नीचे settled हुआ है, जिसे हम sediment कहते हैं, उसको disturb ना हो. So this pouring of supernatant liquid into another vessel without disturbing the sediments is known as decantation. When once decantation has been done, you will notice that there are still some of the particles left in the container. So what you can do to minute impurities from the water, from the liquid. So what you will do there, you will take another container and you can use a strainer or a filter paper. You all must have seen a strainer at your homes. You use strainers to separate the tea leaves from the tea. You remember? Have everyone seen that strainer? So what you can do that, you can use a strainer or you can use a filter paper. Filter paper also you must have seen, we use filter paper in the laboratory. Can see it in the school lab. So what you have to do to remove these minute impurities, you will take a container and you will put a strainer or a filter paper at the mouth of the container. And after that, you will pour this liquid with the impurities into the another container. What will happen? The clean water will pour down in the container while the impurities will be left behind at the filter paper or the strainer. The clean water that pours down is termed as filtrate, while the impurities that remains at the top of the filter paper is termed as residue. And this process of separation of liquid from a solid liquid mixture by using a filter paper or strainer is often termed as filtration. Let us look at the definition once again. Filtration is a process in which solid impurities are removed from liquid mixtures using a filter paper. So this was sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Our next topic is evaporation and condensation. Students, you all must have once heard this term evaporation. You must have heard this term. So evaporation is basically the changing of water into vapor form by heating it. So how can we use this method to separate anything? So give me one answer. If I ask you to separate sugar from the solution of sugar and water, can you separate sugar from the solution of sugar and water by using any of the process we studied like sedimentation, decantation or filtration? Can you separate sugar from the solution of sugar and water by using any of the processes like sedimentation, decantation and No, you cannot separate sugar from the solution of sugar and water by using these kind of methods. But we can separate it by using the method of evaporation. How? We can. I will explain you. Please look carefully on the method. So first of all, take some solution of sugar and water in a china dish. You will heat the china dish on the spirit lamp and heat it up. When you will start heating it up, you will notice that after some time, the liquid from the container will start rising up in the form of vapor. The liquid will vaporize and start rising up in the form of vapor, leaving the solid particles behind. This changing of liquid into vapor form is known as evaporation. When the liquid part from the solution will rise up in the form of vapor, it will leave the solid particles behind, that is the sugar particles. So in this way we can separate the sugar particles from the solution of sugar and water. So did you understand what is evaporation? Please look at the definition once again. The process of separating solute from solvent by heating is called evaporation. Here the solute was sugar and the solvent was sugar water solution. So in this way, could you see that we separated the sugar from the solution of sugar and water by using the process of evaporation. Now what is condensation? You must or must not have heard this term, but condensation is the process by which the vapor form is converted back to its liquid form. How can I look at the blackboard? I will explain to you. See, when a liquid is vaporizing up in from this container, what you will do? You will take a chill plate or you will take a plate and keep some ice cubes above this plate. When the liquid vaporizing